Peace and love, Aunt Mommies and Uncle Paws. This is Julia from offreborns.com back with another speed paint video. And this video, I will be transforming a blank kit into this beautiful doll that you just saw. So here's the blank kit starting out. This is the Nino kit, and it is sculpted by Chinza. And I had so much fun bringing this kit to life. This is actually a doll that I painted and is already adopted. It is a custom order doll. And yes, it is already with its new mom. So shout out to you for purchasing this doll and asking me to paint this sculpt. This was a lot of fun to paint. As some of you guys know, Chinza is a sculptor who specializes in making dolls with different abilities that represent people with different abilities. And this particular doll is sculpted to represent a baby who was born with achondroplasia, or short stature, as some people like to say. And so this doll has all of the characteristics of that. It has a larger head than would be normal for a newborn baby, but the limbs are about the same size. So if you go back to the picture, and I'll show more pictures at the end of this video, that is why the baby is characteristics of that. And I did add a belly plate, which I had in my stash. I had a belly plate that I felt really matched and made the baby look really chubby and everything. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Before I get into talking about other things, I just want to tell you, I am so excited, everybody, because I have released my All For Reborns professional air dry paints. These are the paints that you see me use in all of my speed paint videos, and then if you've purchased some of my tutorials, you have seen me use these paints as well. And I'm so happy to be able to offer them to you. If you are somebody who already paints, or you're thinking about getting into painting reborn baby dolls, this paint is amazing. I've formulated this particular paint formula, and I perfected it for years now, and I love it, and I really think you will too. Check it out at offreborns.com to give it a try. And speaking of offreborns.com, there are a lot of things over there. I have mini silicone reborn baby dolls for sale, as well as reborn cuddle babies at the moment that are ready to ship. I also have a reborn baby doll that is ready to ship too. I do take custom orders from time to time, so always check out what's new. And the best way to stay in the loop is to subscribe to my mailing list. It's free to subscribe. When you go to offreborns.com, something pops up and asks you if you'd like to join. I do send out messages here and there. I don't, you know, overwhelm your email box with things. So if you want to know what's going on and when new dolls are available, exciting updates, make sure you check that out. So if you've been watching, which I hope you're paying attention, all this talking that I'm doing, I'm doing a lot of detailing of little Nino. I do have tutorials on my website, and I have some more that I plan to come out with in the future. This video really isn't intended to be a tutorial. It's really just showing the process of what I do. And, you know, I hope that you find that really enjoyable to watch. So grab some tea, grab some coffee, grab a snack, and sit back and relax and enjoy this speed paint video. I will come back at the end to give you a little bit more information about Nino. And I keep saying he, but I actually made this into a girl at the customer's request. When you order a custom order, that's what you get to do. You get to, you know, make your requests known, and I use my artistic expression to bring those requests to life. So it's really like a marriage of the artist with the customer's ideas. So that's why it's always recommended that you only order a custom doll from somebody whose work you really love and you want to have their work in your collection, or you really dig their vibe. You know, it's something about them that you just really want to have and to have a piece of their artwork. So yeah, and I just also wanted to say thank you guys so much for watching. If you're watching this far and listening to me, make sure you give a thumbs up to this video. It really helps out my channel with the algorithm, and also subscribe. All right, I'll be back at the end. Enjoy, enjoy, enjoy. Thank you.
We'll be right back.
right, so little Nino is painted and looking so lifelike. Now it's time to add hair. For this doll, I am adding human hair at the customer's request. This hair is something that I pick up at my local beauty supply store. I have like a store near me that has a ton of like human hair, wigs, everything. So it was actually really cool to go and choose out the hair for this doll. This is a brand, I wish I knew what it was off the top of my head, but it's like really realistic hair. It's very soft, especially when you add like conditioner and product. It behaves just like human hair. Now, I do have a full recording of me doing this doll's hair. I'm not gonna put that in this video since it's just speed painting, but I did want to show a little bit of the process. I will upload a separate video that has the entire hair process because I feel like it's important to show that too, because it after, as you'll see as I'm doing the doll, I have to, you know, do certain things to make it look right, and then in the end I give it a haircut and style it and all that. And since Nino's head is larger, it's almost like rooting a toddler, so it took a really long time. I think it took me about a week to get this doll's hair, and that is all the hair. I mean, Nino had a hair full of head. I mean, a head full of hair. All right. Signing this doll like I do all my others and getting ready for the assembly process. This is so fun when I do this because it's like I get to see the baby come to life. Look at those little short little legs, a little short little chunky legs. So it's so cool because it's like a newborn baby with the larger head. Now I did see some people who did this kit that made it to be like a toddler sculpt, and I thought that was really cool, but look at it, it's so adorable. This is such a adorable baby. I should say look at her, not look at it. Look at her. Aww. And she's got her little baby hairs now, and you can see how it dried into a curly fro, which is what the customer wanted. She wanted just a lot of curly hair, like a loose curly fro. And the cool thing about this hair, I've used it in other toddlers, and you can still give it that wet curly look too. You can do multiple things with it. So anyway, just testing out her body and her weighting and everything, and getting ready to do her photo shoot. Taking a couple pictures for the gram and for social media. I always like to do that. And yeah, aww, looks so realistic and so peaceful, especially with the belly plate. I love how the veins show, and it's hard to catch it in this particular lighting, but it just looks so amazing. And now we're gonna add a headband, and Nino really looks like a little girl now, so maybe we should call her Nina. But look at her, this is so adorable. I love her outfit, and this little blanket is one that my mom gave me. So sometimes I'll send home the dolls with blankets from my mom, or I'll use the blankets in photo shoots. And right now I'm just changing her and doing little last minute positioning to get her ready for her photo shoots. In the end, I will also show more pictures of Nina from her photo shoot. Thank you. And here is one final look at Nino or Nina in her outfit. And these are photos from her photo shoot. Each time I send a doll home, I always send home photos of the doll to my customers who order a custom order. I really hope one day, if you're watching this, that I can make your dream baby. And thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe, like, and go ahead and watch another video on my channel. And I'll see you in the next one. Make sure you click that bell, turn on your notifications so you don't miss the next upload. Peace and love, and be blessed.